sons. And yes, I mean, their math is right, but at the end of the day, this is a tattoo. So at some point, if you're going to start explaining the physics of a book, you really have to stay within the mythology of the book. And I'm just going to guess that they would have seen two sons. So as much as that's a great explanation, I highly recommend reading it. I think that because it doesn't, because there are explanations that fit within the world, that that isn't, that going outside of that world is not necessary. And so, with these complicated Miller-Kobe cycles, I just feel the need to show something scary from Brandon.
Don't listen to it. Crows are all liars. I know a story about a crow.
I hate your stories.
I know a story about a boy who hated stories. I could tell you about Sir Duncan at all. Those were always your favourites.
Those weren't my favourites. My favourites were the scary ones.
Oh, my sweet summer child, what do you know about fear? Fear is for the winter, when the snows fall 100 feet deep. Fear is for the long night, when the sun hides for years, and children are born and live and die, all in darkness. That is the time for fear, my little lord, when the white walkers move through the woods. Thousands of years ago, there came a night that lasted a generation. Kings froze to death in their castles, same as the shepherds in their huts. And women smothered their babies rather than see them starve, and wept, and felt the tears freeze on their cheeks. So is this the sort of story that you like? In that darkness, the white walkers came for the first time. They swept through cities and kingdoms, riding their dead horses, hunting with their packs of pale spiders, big as hounds.
And they came to conquer the seven kingdoms.
doing was no easy stuff.
Guys.
research you put in there, they will eventually write it off. Nothing is 100%. So dragons, in addition to, you know, burning stuff down, also can create one of the most amazing anti-white walker weapons ever, dragon glass. So before talking about what dragon glass is exactly, it helps to have an understanding of what glass is. Glass is a pretty cool substance. You can have, and trust me, everyone's had long arguments, solid or slow-moving liquid. I highly recommend watching the pitch drop experiment. It's the longest going experiment of nothing happening. There's a video cam. It's, I think, 80 years old now. It's a funnel with pitch, which seems very solid, but it's actually glassy. And it's a slow moving liquid. And it's dripped 7 times in 8 years. So there's some great stories about the most interesting thing of nothing happening. But it really is a great story. And the history of it is fantastic. And it's things like, no one saw it actually drip. They had webcams that failed at the wrong time. They had a guy that went to the bathroom at the wrong time. Because when it breaks, it does it so quickly. They had people around the clock watching, and someone walked away to answer a phone call. I mean, spectacular misses. They finally filmed it this year. I guess they filmed it last year, but this dropped. But what glass is something that is melted and then quenched, meaning it's cooled extremely quickly. And so when something's cooled slowly, it has the ability to have, the molecules can like move around and find their buddies and figure out where they like to be and sit in their chairs and come up with this ordered state. And so you have something like silicon oxide. What it wants to do is this. If you basically quench something, you're playing weapons, every person forging these weapons, had a secret magic way to quench them. And so you make them really hot, and if you're just making your average iron sword, you just throw it in some water, it quenches, done. These needed magic. And so what they did is they quenched it in special things, and interestingly enough, they called it dragon's blood. And I thought that was a really fascinating historical fact. They quenched it in dragon's blood, which was really goat or donkey blood.
You can reinforce it like pycrete, the sort of.
That's a possibility. The problem is the what you really need to do from a physics perspective to stop the problem is take some of the weight off the bottom. Mm. So if you had like a metal scaffold kind of throughout and then had the blocks on top of it, that would probably work as long as you're finding some way to mitigate that pressure on the bottom. Mm. So like rebar or something might be a really good idea, but I mean that's why you have rebar in buildings. So that would be, that's actually a really good idea. I don't know. I mean, that I was going to say, that seems like a lot of work, but so is an ice wall. So. Really? Okay. That would be. Yeah. Oh.
Heavy water. Water is normally H2O. If the H is deuterium, that actually freezes well above ordinary freezing water. It's kind of weird.
Yeah.
Oh, so George R. Martin said that he pulled those numbers for the wall just like out of thin air when he was writing the book and didn't realize how like awful the wall was until like he saw it for HBO. So is there like a reasonable height it could have been? Or just in general is just like the pressure really, like not good?
I think at some point it's gonna be the point at which you're gonna have a pyramid that is not at a pitch you could just walk up is going to be low enough that ladders would be okay. So it's like the trade-offs are that if you can construct an ice wall, you need it to be above a certain height. And I mean, if at 700 feet, it's like 250 elephants. Like, it, you know, even just looking, there's no way you're going to get. I don't think there's a way, and I'd honestly have to do the math, because sometimes, any problems like this, I always like to say I have to do the math, because often I'm surprised. So often I sit down and do the numbers, and I'm like, oh my god. Like one time someone asked me if we could make a death ray out of laser pointers, and I was like, no. And I did the math of the wattage of a laser pointer, and you only need about 100,000 laser pointers, and if you assume a certain size, you could actually get that in your backyard. Anyway, so I always like to do math. So don't take this, you know, as gospel because I haven't done the numbers. My guess is when you get to a point that the pitch is steep enough to be defensive, it's too small to be useful anyway.
There is actually science in pyramid building that the early Egyptians built very steep pyramids and it all collapsed. If you dribble sand in a pile, it all goes to something like 35 something degrees, and that
and the plant matter they used that made all that alchemy happen. And they, my guess is there's a way you could do it, but not by forging steel. I mean, you can make it, just not the way that one forges steel. You can make something, so it would be a different process, but have not found a way to do that.
So I noticed you like to use elephants as your unit of weight. Have you ever considered anything else? Like, for example, the largest observed black hole in the universe is roughly 1.57 octillion Toyota Corollas.
Perspective, I have to ask, what kind of elephant are we talking about?
Oh, an African bush elephant.
Okay.
A male African bush elephant. The females are about 2/3 of the weight of the male, so the male African bush elephant is
worse. The people who are working on the Damascus steel, are they using the right quenching techniques?
Yes, they're quenching it in acid, not urine. Acid. Thank you.